Welcome back, comrades. Today we're listening to Battle of Moscow. As you can see, I have different setup because I realized the old one did not work effectively. So, here we are. To take out Sabaton's defense of Moscow. Let's dive right into video. I'm also entirely sorry for that. In case you don't like the Russian accent, I will stop doing it. However, maybe I'll continue to do it. The fate of Russia would have been decided at Moscow. It surely would have been a heavy blow to Soviet morale, but I don't think it would have actually dictated the push to the east. I think it would have been more of a ideological victory, because there is no way Russia would have capitulated after the fall of Moscow. Even after even if Moscow, Leningrad, and Stalingrad failed, there's no way Russia surrendering. They're probably going to fight to the bitter end. And there's no way the Nazis can make it any further than the Ural Mountains, so I think, really, if Moscow fell, the Soviets couldn't do much about it. Yeah, so out of morale, the war basically just come to a standstill. It also doesn't mention the other fronts, too, like North Africa, Italy, and the Western Front that would probably eventually open up. Like a lot of the Great Patriotic War, Zhukov was in control of most of the operations. He fought Japan in the non-declared border conflict in Manchuria, and he would obviously end the war, leading the assault on Berlin. I have no idea if he marched into. I don't know if he ended the war with Japan though when he invaded Manchuria. But when it happened. I don't know if he led them 1.5 million men that ended World War II in the Pacific, though. You obviously see the Stukas trying to bomb Moscow, which is something nobody ever actually talks about, but there were attempts to bomb the city of Moscow, but the anti-aircraft defenses were so stiff that the bombers could never make it close, so it eventually got shut down. I wonder what T-34 they're going to use, because, interestingly, out of the 10 T-34-76 tanks built by the Red Army, all 10 of them were present at the Battle of Moscow, and all 10 were also completely destroyed. So, yeah, that's what happened to the T-34-76, despite how common it might be in War Thunder. That's right. I find it funny they use an MG-42 in 1941. Let's go. The defense of Moscow was literally one of those places, which is, your orders are to don't fucking retreat, stand there and die, basically. One of the only other times this happened was in the Great War, when the Imperial German Army was pushing the French and the BDF back towards Paris. Eventually, the French general just said, look, just stop retreating, and they did, and it caused what we know as trench warfare today. Right. I have no idea if there was hand-to-hand combat in the defense of Moscow. I know, definitely, somewhere, well, not definitely, but I do believe at some point they mentioned a typhoon wave. That references Operation Typhoon, which was the operation to invade and take Moscow. I 100% missed that originally doing this. I don't know why, but that's basically this video. April 30th, I hope to release something you've never seen on this channel before, which is an oversimplified reaction. You'll see what it is when it comes out, because I will not tell you here, but that's basically it. I got videos planned for basically the rest of the year, so I should be releasing them, not regularly, but I should be releasing them and not going AWOL for about a year.